Welcome to the Incubation Talks. My name is Eline Mures, Communications Manager at Dutch Game Garden. We're here at Gamescom 2018, and we're going to have a Q&A with Michael Liebe. Michael, welcome. Could you please introduce yourself?
Sure. My name is Michael Liebe. I'm from Berlin. I'm CEO and founder of a company called Booster Space. We are mainly an event specialist, but I'm also here and especially here at Gamescom as representative of Kickstarter under the title Outreach Games Europe. It's a kind of community management, marketing and consultancy.
What do you think developers should do to prepare for a Kickstarter campaign?
If you finally decide to be so brave and go onto crowdfunding and especially Kickstarter and you want to bring out your game, So the first rule is start as early as possible. Prepare everything, prepare the numbers, prepare the marketing assets, and start building your community as soon as possible. As basically, I always say, if you don't want to announce a game yet, start talking about your team, your company and stuff. Go out there, build your community as early as possible. That's the most important thing. And then if you have a strong community, the campaign will run more smoothly, definitely.
Of course, one of the things that you have to decide when doing a crowdfunding campaign is decide the targets. How do you determine the amount of money that you want to raise?
It depends on so many factors. There's no like fixed rule on what to do and how to do it or how to set your goal. And it depends on what you need as well. Like for most people, it's not only about the money, it's more about the outreach, the marketing effect, so they can work with a lower funding goal and are happy to reach people. You need to be as transparent as possible. So if you like do a game and you say I need 20k euros from the Kickstarter community, everybody out there knows for 20k euros you cannot do a game. So where does the rest of the money come from? Explain that, be as transparent as possible on the budgets you have and where it comes from and how you will use the budget in the end. Then don't miscalculate in the end, like Kickstarter shipment and fulfillments also cost money, many people forget that. If you want to do crowdfunding, you need to be out there. I mean, that's a thing many people underestimate. And then the focus on channels. The newsletter is actually the strongest channel for conversion of your community. So many people forget about setting up a newsletter campaign.
What other channels do the developers use, or what do you see as very effective?
Well, what most people do is Twitter in the indie developer scene especially, and Facebook. That's good tools. Definitely also for Kickstarter, Twitter works quite well. Facebook, with the new algorithms, it's a bit more challenging, so you might need to invest money into Facebook for the advertisements. But the newsletter is the strongest tool. So wherever you go, ask people if they want to be part of your newsletter. Set up the subscribe button on your website as soon as possible.
Of course, Kickstarter has the ability to add backer tiers. Do you have any advice on like how to decide what those backer tiers should be, or any best practices?
Stretch goals, quick and dirty. Ask Tom from Ico Partners, Thomas Bidot. He will always tell you, no, don't announce stretch goals. And I agree with him. But prepare stretch goals, yes. But just don't announce them. That's the main rule.
So you should announce them when you already reach your main targets?
Exactly. I always say if you like are at 80% of the main target and of the following stretch goal, you announce the stretch goals. Because of course you need them to motivate people to ongoingly back your project. And to like have the battle ongoing to reach the next goal. But that's also like in communication processes a good reason to communicate. And it looks awkward if you say I want 20k, but my game will be awesome if I get 150k. So what do you get with 20k? Then people think it's not worth anything, the 20k. So that's another side part to it.
And you mentioned the pledges. Any best practices there?
Be creative on the one hand, but don't be too creative. Keep it simple and keep it understandable. Find something which can be Kickstarter exclusive. The community loves that. If you really want to do physical stuff, think 300 times about it if you want to do it and if it makes sense. A t-shirt of an unknown game nobody will want. But something creative like a 3D printed model of this awesome super mech, people might want. But then production costs, blah. So calculate your production costs and shipment costs for the physical goods and find something Kickstarter exclusive and be brave in asking for higher pledges. Like, okay, like Steam style, 10 euros, early access, low budget sales are okay, but the Kickstarter community likes creative, innovative stuff they cannot get anywhere else. And people are willing to spend 1,000, 250, 500 euros if the idea, the team, and the pledge is creative enough and cool enough.
So let's say I'm running a Kickstarter campaign and I'm like halfway through the month. What things can I use to like keep the campaign going so that people don't lose interest?
Yeah, that's the biggest challenge. I mean, it's always you have a high rise in the first 48 hours, then everybody panics, and then the last 48 hours it goes up again. And this middle phase is super challenging, and people think, yeah, there's nothing to talk about. But no, you can, like, say, do social goals, for example, share goals. Kickstarter Live is a very good tool for video game producers. It's like Twitch in Kickstarter, and you can directly pledge out of the live stream in the campaign. That's a good thing to do, like showing updates and working with the community you already have. Like, have interesting updates, like not, hey, we reached 80%, that's awesome, nobody's interested in that. People are interested in, hey, look at this new character our graphic designer just did. We did this integration in Unity and it worked. Of course you did all of that before. Sure, yeah, but you announce it during the campaign to keep the story running and the interest coming.
Basically creating a lot of content that you release in this 1 month.
Yes, yeah. And updates help you be ranked higher in the Kickstarter platform. So our algorithm supports communities where there's action. But updates are only valuable if you get likes or comments and feedback.
Speaking of the front page of Kickstarter, usually you see campaigns that are picked by Kickstarter as they are recommended. How do you get that as a developer? How do you get up there on the front page?
Up there on the front page, that's magic. There's really no rule to that. It's new. Like, I don't know if you noticed, before the Kickstarter front page was pretty block-like and all the categories were represented. Now we have a curation team, a sort of editorship team that puts, like, now is the game day, for example, now is the tabletop game day, now is the fashion, now music, whatever day. We want to keep it like surprising, like not Tuesday's game day, for example, that would be boring. So the curation team has their own rules and own philosophy, and it depends a lot also on what's going on in society, what's the discourse doing. And for games, to get out there, the most important thing is to be connected to us, like with Anya, Luke, me, or Trin from the games team, because if we work with people, it's more interesting for us also than to just be robots on behind our computers. So reach out, say hello, and share your needs, and then
How do people reach out?
Send me an email.
Yeah? All right.
You can put it in the comment section or whatever in the video description.
Cool. After a campaign is finished, let's say I met my goal, how do you move forward from that? What would you advise people like to do first?
Well, first is open a bottle of champagne.
Yeah.
That's the most important. Invite some friends, have a nice party, and say thank you to every single backer. Keep communicating. It can always happen, especially in video game development, that there's a delay, you have technical issues, I don't know, your designer broke a leg. Be transparent about it. Like, if something happens wrong, tell the people that something happened and you're working on it, and then come up with a solution. So continue using our Kickstarter platform for the updates, continue building your newsletter and preparing for the launch, and please, if possible, don't delay too much. You promised something, so try to keep that promise. Like, that's taking away something you wanted to ask me in the end, is like, my main recommendation is stay realistic and be pragmatic. It's more important to get something out there than to work for 3 years on something perfect. The experience people want to get is your game. Of course, it shouldn't be broken, but some decisions just take too long. It's more important to make a decision, fix it, put it in the game, and get out there within your scheduled timeline. Because money will dry out, and your community will lose interest. So you need to get out there in the time frame you announced.
Okay, I think it's good to wrap it up there. But to summarize the most important points, first of all, prepare and start building your community as soon as possible. Then when running a campaign, have a lot of content ready and be transparent about what you're doing. And of course, reach out to the Kickstarter people. They can help you and give you advice about running your campaign. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good luck.